It kind of shook the whole high school.
There seemed to be a window of kids that were like the 91s.
Exactly, and they went to Uxbridge together, like they went to high school together.
Welcome to the town of Uxbridge, a town with a population of 20,000 people, with one high school where everyone knows everything about everyone and nothing ever happens. Or so that's what it was like until late 2008, when the teenagers of this town began to face one tragic loss after another. Andrew Allison, a pastor for St. Paul's Church in Leasdale, Ontario, has affiliated 7 out of 13 funerals for people under the age of 22 in the past 5 years.
With young people, it is different. There is a sense, a complete sense of, this is wrong, this shouldn't be this way. So, you know, I don't think we've ever had a young person's funeral here with less than 600 people. Sometimes it's been 1,000. So it does, it draws the community out. And so I need to be aware of that going into it. Nobody expects a young person to die. 50 maybe, 80, you know, it just feels differently. Grandma's gone, had a good run. People still cry, but there is this sense of, okay. But parents putting their kids in the grave, different story.
Darren Benson is an Uxbridge Secondary School graduate and had this to say about how these tragedies affected his town.
I think it does to the extent because we are a small town, people tend to know each other more. We only have the one high school, right? So one person, if like when someone passes away, everybody knows about it. It's, I think Uxbridge is kind of a special case for it. I don't know if it's common to have 13 deaths. It's like 13 deaths under 22 in 5 years or something like that. I don't think that's a normal statistic for us to have.
If I die young, bury me inside, lay me down.
In Darren's first year at university, he got a devastating phone call telling him one of his close friends, Jennifer Borgford, and her boyfriend, Mark Hayes, were killed in a car accident.
It was just shock, really. That's the only thing that came in or comes into your head. You just can't believe what you're hearing, and it really takes a long time for it to actually sink in before you realize what has actually happened.
In 2012, Dylan French took his own life, leaving behind friends, family, and girlfriend Katie Tower.
I kind of knew something bad happened when we went to the Leafs game the night before, and then he went home to Uxbridge because his mom was supposed to take him to Waterloo the next day because he went to school. He went to Laurier. And he just didn't show up. So his mom emailed him and was calling him and he wouldn't answer. So she emailed me and was like, hey, like, is Dylan still with you? I was like, no, he's not. He went home last night on the bus. Like, I walked him to the bus and, he just didn't show up. And, then like, I just knew.
Dylan's passing came as a shock to everyone after one of his friends, not even a year before, did the same thing.
Him and Ryan were roommates. So he knew exactly, and they went to Uxbridge together, like they went to high school together. He knew exactly how it felt to have someone to do that to them. And he saw Beverly, like his mom and his sister and his brother, and how it affected them and how it affected all his friends that all grew up together in Uxbridge for so long, and felt it himself. So the fact that he did that to everyone else just boggles my mind.
Not only is it hard for all the young people dealing with the loss of their former classmates, the pastor shares his feelings and sympathies for their parents.
The funeral again, and here's all these kids, and they're all crying. It's too much for them, and I know mom and dad are going to deal with year after decade of loss of, you know, now Dylan would be doing this, now Ryan would be doing that, now Tegan would be doing this, and they're not.
For Spoke TV, I'm Molly Mercier.